This is CN2 Sports.
Cyclists are gearing up for a good cause. The 24 Hours of Booty, it's a national cycling event held once a year to help raise money for cancer research. Well, it will be held in Charlotte on July the 28th and 29th at Myers Park. 24 Hours of Booty is a 24-hour, 3-mile loop that attracts more than 1,200 riders. Well, one man, along with a few of his friends from Rock Hills Bike Club, well, they're trying to recruit a large enough group to try and ride this year. We caught up with them last night, Monday night, during their regular night bike ride to get ready for that 24-hour event.
Just people on bikes going out, swapping stories, having fun. There's bands, there's food, they're just hanging out. It's a good time beyond just rolling on a bicycle.
Last year, 24 Hours of Booty in Charlotte raised more than $17 million. The Indianland High School girls soccer team is advancing to the 3A state championship game. It beat Pendleton 5-0 Monday. The Lady Warriors will now face Brooklyn Casey High School this Saturday at 1 p.m. there at Irmo High School.
In other schools throughout the Tri-County, the Northwestern baseball team defeating Westside 10-0 in the upper state tournament winner's bracket. Fort Mill seeing its season come to an end with a 10-2 loss to Boiling Springs. Louisville baseball moving on to the upper state finals with a 4-3 win over McBee. In softball, Louisville beating Lamar 10-0, Clover beating J.L. Mann 4-0, Buford edging Landrum 7-6, and Andrew Jackson snuck past Girard 8-7. Well, USC men's basketball tweeting this Tuesday, good luck to Lancaster's Sindarius Thornwell, who starts the NBA draft combine today. Mark your calendars. The NBA draft gets underway on June 22nd.
Well, the Winthrop women's tennis team is preparing to take on the Tennessee Volunteers in the opening round of the NCAA tournament. Check out some highlights from practice this week with those Lady Eagles there on the court. Winthrop and the Lady Vols will square off this Friday, May the 12th at 1 p.m. on the campus of Duke University. Well, this Wednesday, May the 10th, college baseball returns to BB&T Ballpark, home to the Charlotte Knights. The Davidson Wildcats will host Winthrop University. The game starts at 6:05, and tickets are just $10. We are just 10 weeks away from the city of Rock Hill hosting the state's first world championship, and you can get involved.
Starting July 22nd through the 30th, Rock Hill will host the BMX World Championships. This will be the biggest international sporting event in South Carolina's history. More than 40 countries will be represented by more than 3,000 athletes and coaches, with over 20,000 spectators anticipated. A schedule of volunteer opportunities, dates, and times are now available by going to featured links there on CN2.com. And congrats to Chester High School senior Jaslyn Young receiving word she will be the South Carolina State University cheer team. Nice work, Jaslyn. I bet she's excited.
Yes, it takes a lot of hard work, and of course, hopefully that came with some scholarship money to at least pay for nothing else, maybe just the books. Buying those college books, it costs a lot of money.
I'm sure it'll be a great year for you. We're excited about all of our graduates.
We are, and of course, what, in a couple weeks, May 20th, I think around that time, the high school graduation season will get underway, and then welcome to the workforce.
CN2 will be airing a lot of those graduations, so stay tuned for those details. And thanks for watching CN2.
Have a good night.